Peace and blessings, power people. This is your homegirl, Tama Aziz Serwa, pioneer of the womb sauna and the movement to let the womb be heard. I'm always thrilled when I have an opportunity to hop online and post something to YouTube and share it with you. And so we're just going to have a heart to heart. I'm going to share what's on my heart today. I have been very reflective, going through some amazing shifts in my life, intense emotionally. But what I have discovered in my life is it's in those intense emotional moments that I really get another layer of understanding of who I really am and what I really want to do with myself. And so I embrace it. I do not resist the purge. So in my purging season, the message that keeps coming to me is about unconditional love. And some of you who've been working with me as of recent, you've heard me say that I genuinely believe that love is the cure for it all. Fibroids, infertility, painful cycles, depression, anxiety, bipolar. I mean, no matter what it is, poverty, no matter what it is, love is the cure for it all. And so as I've been applying these principles, even in my own self-care regimen, I want to share with you an experience that I had with my Reiki practitioner. I asked her before my session to read 1 Corinthians 13, which for those of you who are familiar with the Bible, you know, is the love chapter. It defines what love is. And I said, you know what? I really feel like the intention I want to set for this session needs to align with my truth that love is the cure for it all. Will you read that into my body before we get started? And I laid on the table and she did. And let me just say, that was one of the most vivid spiritual experiences I have ever had in my life as of today. And I was able to get such powerful information from God in that Reiki session. And the master teachers, the ascendant ones, came and met me in that experience and taught me things about compassion and love that I needed to know. I want to share this moment with you. I want to activate something in your womb, in your heart. And words are vibrations, words are energy, and I do believe that by hearing this powerful message that I'm going to share with you, that it will align you with love. Unconditional, unapologetic love, cosmic love, divine love. If you can feel love, receive love, and give love, you will have a different body. You will have a different life. It will impact your bank account. It will impact your way of communicating. It will impact your healing process from things of your childhood. Love is everything. And you cannot heal your womb without self-love and without self-acceptance and without self-compassion. And so no matter what you're going through in your healing journey right now, Tama has enough love within her to pour it out through the ethers and the world wide web. So I want to share with you the vibration of 1 Corinthians 13. And may it resonate with you. May you feel the love in it. And may it activate the next phase of your healing journey and your knowledge of yourself and your alignment with God and the Most High. So let's do it. 1 Corinthians 13. I'm going to read it from the New Living Translation because I love that translation. It is modern language. You know, takes out the thou and the shout and all of that. All right. So if I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but did not love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. If I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans, and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains, but did not love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor, even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I did not love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. Love. Again, that's 1 Corinthians 13, verses 1 through 7. And I'm going to bring it home with these last few verses, starting at verse 8. Prophecy, speaking in unknown languages, special knowledge, what we call today being conscious, will become useless. But love will last forever. Now, our knowledge is partial and incomplete, and even the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when the time of perfection comes, these partial things will become useless. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now we see things imperfectly, like puzzling reflections in a mirror. But then we will see everything with perfect clarity. All that I know now is partial and incomplete, but then I will know everything completely, just as God now knows me completely. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. For the sake of the vibration of this message, I'm going to read it all through together one more time. And as I read this, feel free to use this energy of love, surrender, acceptance in your daily life. This right here, these principles, and I hope you don't get hung up on where these principles come from, they're universal. These principles will change you, not just at an intellectual level, but at a cellular level. So I want to encourage you to speak these words of truth over yourself every day for the next 7 days. It can be in the morning, it could be in the afternoon, it could be at night, doesn't even matter. Speak these principles about love over yourself for the next 7 days. And then take inventory of the impact that it's had on you. So I'm going to read it one more time, straight through. And then we will continue our conversations on another time. So again, if I could speak all the languages of earth and of angels, but did not love others, I would only be a noisy gong or a clanging cymbal. if I had the gift of prophecy, and if I understood all of God's secret plans and possessed all knowledge, and if I had such faith that I could move mountains but did not love others, I would be nothing. If I gave everything I have to the poor and even sacrificed my body, I could boast about it. But if I did not love others, I would have gained nothing. Love is patient and kind. Love is not jealous or boastful or proud or rude. It does not demand its own way. It is not irritable, and it keeps no record of being wronged. It does not rejoice about injustice, but rejoices whenever the truth wins out. Love never gives up, never loses faith, is always hopeful, and endures through every circumstance. Prophecy and speaking in unknown languages and special knowledge will become useless, but love will last forever. Now, our knowledge is partial and incomplete, and even the gift of prophecy reveals only part of the whole picture. But when the time of perfection comes, these partial things will become useless. When I was a child, I spoke and thought and reasoned as a child. But when I grew up, I put away childish things. Now we see things imperfectly, like puzzling reflections in a mirror. But then we will see everything with perfect clarity. All that I know now is partial and incomplete, but then I will know everything completely, just as God now knows me completely. Three things will last forever: faith, hope, and love. And the greatest of these is love. Be blessed. Know that you are loved. And know that love is absolutely the cure for it all. Love of yourself, love of the divine, love of others. We would have so much less suffering in this world and within ourselves, within our wombs, if we could just let love flow. So, may that bless you. And I encourage you to share the love challenge that the Womb Sauna is doing through this clip with others. Recruit them to let love reign in their consciousness for the next 7 days. To speak these powerful words over themselves as well for the next 7 days. So you can hit share and share this video and share the challenge, and may it spread like a wildfire, and more people align with the vibration of this message of love. I love you, and I hope you have a blessed day. Peace.
Broken hearts everywhere, from stepping on love, we don't care. Somebody tell me what we gon' do. Even though it's plenty to share, people hungry in the streets, it ain't fair. But you don't think about it until it's you.